Good afternoon. In this video, I will show you how to use the Open, Write, Read, and Close System Call, Linux System Call, in order to write or read a binary file. So usually you can use the fopen, fwrite, fread, and fclose System Call that are libraries, C library, to write or read a binary file on old operating system. If you want, you can do the same things using directly system calls. Actually, in this case, you can run this code only on a Unix, Linux operating system. In this easy example, I will show you how to write an array of structures into the file system and how to read it. So if we go in the example, you can see that here we have our data structure in which we can store a name up to 50 character and the base slash 0 that identify the finish of the string, an unsigned integer that is an identifier, and a floating point number. Here I declare an array of dimension 2 as an example, and I fill the first element of the array with the name Steven, this integer, and this floating point. Then I fill the second element of the array with the name Giulia, this integer, and this floating point. Now I use the most complex function of this system call, that is the open system call. Why complex? Because the open system call, we will see, has three arguments. If you want it to use to open a file in a write mode, if you want only to read a file, this function has only two arguments. So the first argument in any case is the file name, in this case out.binary. Then we have the second argument that in which we have to explain to the open system call how we want to open this file. For instance, here we want to open the file in write only, so we want only to write this file, and as you can see with the OR operator we can pass all the characteristics. The O create means that if the file does not exist in your file system, the file will be created, and the O trunc is used when you open a file that is present in your file system. When you start writing on this file, the previous content of this file is deleted. So if you don't use the otrunc option, if you reopen again this file, you start writing from the beginning, but if the previous file is longest than the current file you are writing, you have the new piece of data following by the remaining part related to the old file. Okay, write only, create trunc. Actually, in Linux you have the man functionality. If you type man open, you have all the options that are a lot of options with the description, but typically the most common options are the one I show you. Then, since you create a new file due to the fact that you have the O create option, in the case the file does not exist, you have to communicate in some way to the operating system which permission must be placed to your file. And for this reason, you have the third argument of the open system call, in which, as you can see, we have a list of constants. Basically, we have three set of constants that finish with the keyword user. So here you can place in this case the read permission and the write permission to the user. So if I write here sig write permission to the user and write permission to the user, I set the read and the write permission to the user of the file, to the owner of the file. Then with this, I set the read permission to the user belonging to my group, and finally I set the read permission to the other. Actually, the resolve the constant with the x, so as I x user, I set the execution permission to the owner of the file. Okay, so with this combination of or, I can choose exactly the permission of the file I need. The open function return a file descriptor that is different with respect to the fopen, because in Linux a file descriptor is an integer number. So as you can see, here we declare the file descriptor as integer. In the case the open return minus 1, this means you have an error, file system is full, you cannot open the file in this directory and so on, and you can exit, sorry, the program. Now, here is the easiest part, because the write system call is really easy. It has three arguments. The first argument is the file descriptor, so the file on which you want to write the data. Then here we have a pointer, so if we open the write system call man-to-write, you see here the prototype, so we have a pointer void, so we can write exactly any kind of data we want to write. And finally the size, that is exactly the amount of bytes we want to write on the file system. Okay, so student is the pointer of the first element of my array of structure, and the data we want to write is size of structure, where size of structure is one of these elements multiply by 2, because our structure currently contains 2 elements. Actually, then you can exactly see that at the end the file that is generated, since size of structure is equal to 60 bytes, will be 120 bytes. After the write operation return the number of bytes that are correctly written into your file, so it returns 120. We can close the file with the close system call that is practically similar to the fclose. If we want to open this file or another file for reading, is more easiest, because now we can use the system call with only two arguments. So as you can see, it's the same system call with a different number of arguments, and as you can see, now we use the read-only constant. Again, it returns minus 1 in the case of error, and here we read our file. I decide to read our file one element by one element, because in some situation usually you don't know how many elements, so how many structures are present in your input file. So the read system call is as first argument the file descriptor, then the pointer on which you want to store the data that are read from your file. So as you can see, I use the ampersand operator that return the memory address. The first element is saved in students of 0, the second in students of 1, and so on. And each time I read a number of byte equal to the dimension of our structure. The read system call returns basically the number of byte that are read. If each time I can read the whole data structure, I cycle here in the while. When at the end I read nothing, this equal operation returns false, and I exit to the while cycle. Finally, I can close my file, and I can print into the screen the things that were read from my file. In order to check and to try to compile this file, I can save the link into my file system, for instance in the slash tmp directory. Now I open a terminal, I go to the tmp directory. Now here there is my file, gcc minus w all in order to have all the warning, binary write file write read c minus output, for instance prog. And now as you can see there is my executable, that is this one, and I can run it as you can see there is a file written in my file system with this dimension, and when the file was read by my program the output is the content of this file. If I check, I try to find the content of the file, as you can see it is binary, so I can not read nothing. At all I can read the content of the two strings that are Steven and Giulia. In this web page you can find the example. Thank you very much for your attention.